Hi Virgo, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your love bite now. Let's see what message wants to show through for you today, Virgo. And these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you and just leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Virgo and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Virgo, let's begin your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. And Virgo, if you're new here, we welcome you. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of our Omkara family. So, and Virgo, if any of you are looking for a personal reading, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. I'm stuttering a little right now because I just saw the Two of Pentacles in reverse, which has come center of my spread. Somebody is on the verge of dropping something, Virgo. Not feeling emotionally happy. Bottom of my spread, see, I have the Queen of Cups in reverse. So feeling very emotional at the moment. Feeling very emotionally drained out. Feeling lack of love. Very, very overwhelmed in your emotions right now. Feeling tired, exhausted, and feeling it's time to drop something. Feeling a lack of love here, no emotional happiness, no balance, and feeling it's time maybe to drop something, drop a conflict maybe of a third party situation possibly, or maybe wanting to work towards something new, wanting something to return, or maybe something hasn't returned. There's a lot of confusion here, Virgo, and things are still not out in the open. There's still a lot of secrets being kept here. So let's start with some dialogue message cards here, Virgo, to see why you're feeling in this state. If you or your partner could say something to you, what that would be. So Virgo and their person spirit, Virgo and their partner, if they could say something to each other. Virgo and their partner, if they could say something to each other. Let's take some from the other deck. Virgo and their person. Virgo and their person. If they could say something to each other now, spirit, what would that be? All right. Let's take a couple more messages from the heart and then we begin your reading. One more. That's it. All right, Virgo, good to go. Let's start your reading. The first card I have here says, it's so frustrating the way you compare me to others. I'm not like anyone else. My success is not measured by my status or material items. I'm unique, authentic, and proud of who I am. Why don't you just see me, my heart, and my soul? I always choose you every damn time, every damn day. You say you want me, but your actions don't match with your words that have come out of your mouth. Damn it, I want you to choose me and show me that you mean it. Take action. Next card. You knowingly brought me into a clusterfuck of a situation. I trusted you to do what was right and you let me down. No wonder this Queen of Cups is feeling that emotionally drained now because of all the delay that's happening in this connection. Feeling very unhappy, feeling a lack of love, feeling the imbalance. I know that you think you broke me, but don't give yourself so much credit. I'm not porcelain. I might have a few cracks, but I let the light in and allowed it to shine back into the world. Don't worry about fixing me so much as you should worry about fixing yourself. I know that it is our destiny to marry and have children together. We are united in a mission to serve God's plan to spread love and light in this world. Our combined gifts are important in this world. I'm planning a romantic trip for us to reconnect. I want to cherish you with loving adoration. Yes, like I said, somebody does want to return here. somebody does want to return here. Okay, so next one says, every night I just want to be home, and home is in your arms. I really need your warmth and affection. There is no one in the world as amazing as you. So I think these messages are for the Queen of Cups. If you're feeling down and out and feeling rejected and unloved, there is somebody who wants to return back to you and adore you. All right, so let's start with an angel blessing card and see if my angels could bless my Virgo gang with a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message, what that would be. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Virgo. Pray. All your prayers are going to soon be answered. Every, you know, teardrop of yours has been registered by the angels. They're listening to everything you say. So be very mindful of your words, Virgo. Okay? Be very, very, very sure of what you want and put your prayer out there, because it will be answered. The universe is listening to each and every word, each sob, each, all your problems. Okay? So keep that faith going. All right. So let's start clarifying these cards, Virgo. Nine of Cups in reverse. Why is the Nine of Cups in reverse, Spirit? Why is there no happiness here? And the feeling of the lack of love? Yeah, somebody was waiting for this brand new start, Virgo. Somebody who's waiting for this brand new start, but they are just thinking and thinking and thinking and overthinking. Maybe it'll happen, maybe it won't. Am I the only one in this situation? And this overthinking is kind of, because maybe this brand new start is wished upon and not happening, there's a feeling of emotional unhappiness, feeling maybe there is no love in this situation, maybe that's why it's not happening. Ace of Cups in reverse, Spirit. Ace of Cups in reverse. Yeah, somebody had a dream. Somebody had a dream of, you know, maybe the happily ever after, being the wife. Yes, see, the minute I said that, I get the Ten of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles. Somebody had this dream that, you know, one day we'll be together. We'll be emotionally happy together. I'll be the spouse. I'll be with them forever and ever, but now, right now, not feeling the love at all. And it's all in the mind. I think it's all in the mind. Maybe you're just kind of creating demons in your head, which are not even present, right? Maybe they, because there's been a delay, somebody has been overthinking to a point of believing that there is no love. There is nothing to be gained anymore in this connection. Temperance in reverse, Spirit. Some imbalance, because maybe somebody said something, somebody was cold, the communication was not as gentle or loving, and that created some kind of an imbalance here. Maybe certain words were said which hurt the other person, and it was taken upon as, oh my God, this is the end now. This is the end. This cannot kind of come back into healing after what, you know, my person has said to me or something like that. Five of Wands in reverse. Five of Wands in reverse. Five of Wands in reverse. Or maybe somebody just does want to come to now and talk about this ending. And but the whole problem is, right now both of you have your swords up. Both of you have your swords up. I have the Queen of Swords here and the King of Swords here. And that's what's creating this imbalance and this feeling that everything has come to an end, and no longer wanting to fight for this connection and drop things. One more, Spirit, for the Five of Wands in reverse. Because there's so much love here, Virgo. There is real, actual love between the two of you. It's just that your perceptions, I think, are different. Both of you have your sword up and, you know, kind of giving up the fight. Who's dropping what, Spirit? This Two of Pentacles in reverse. Who's dropping what? One more. I think this is the Queen of Cups now, who's saying, I've put a lid on that cup of love of mine. And but the love is still there. I think this is the time when you guys will be dropping this fight, ending this fight, because the love is still present. There is a strong chance of a reconciliation here, Virgo. Don't give up that easy. The love is pure, the love is true, from what I feel. The Queen of Cups has suddenly come out upright once again with the Three of Cups. And maybe this is the time that you guys will be dropping this fight altogether and decide to work together after somebody decides to return. Let's see what this is. Three of Pentacles, Spirit. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. I think there's a lot of confusion here. That's about it. It's time that you both saw things from all different sides. Take some time out. This is just confusion. I don't see this as options, okay? This is just a whole lot of confusion as to how to bring about a transformation to this connection once again. I don't see this as the ending. The Death card is either endings or, you know, big transformations. I still do see something transforming in a very big way. What's that, Spirit? What's this Death card? Yeah, somebody's... The whole problem is that somebody's getting a bit impatient here. They've been standing at crossroads for so long that they've been by themselves, alone, worrying, and this is getting feeling more and more of a burden and leading to confusion only in their head. In their brain. So what's this Eight of Cups, Spirit, in reverse? Is that somebody returning? Eight of Cups in reverse. Eight of Cups in reverse. Be a little mindful, Queen of Cups. I think somebody does want to return, or if they do return, and if the offer that they give you is not big enough or strong enough, you may just kind of go back into this mode to say, no, this is a no. I mean, you want a bigger offer. You're not happy with the small offer because you don't want one cup. You don't want four cups. What you want is that Nine of Cups, which is going to be giving you emotional happiness. You are kind of sitting on your throne here to say either you come correct or you don't come at all. Okay? This person, whoever's returning back, the offer given by them may not seem big enough. And now that you've kind of found your self-worth, you may be kind of saying, hey, you know, now this time it's going to be my way or the highway. And that's going to lead to, again, to a lot of confusion and a lot of silence between the two of you. Yes, this could lead to a tower moment. Be very mindful, Virgo. Be very, very mindful. And it could bring another end, or at least, stagnation to this relationship. High Priestess, Spirit. High Priestess. Same thing again, Virgo. I'm talking to the feminine in this dynamic. I don't know, Virgo, whether this is you or this is your cross watcher, but somebody could be expecting more of an offer than they'll be getting. Somebody does want to come and apologize, but the other person, I think, is sulking a little bit. I don't want to talk to you. Either you offer me, you know, equal partnership, equal give and take, commitment once and for all, or I'm going to hold my ground here. Okay, so I think somebody's been overthinking and been very worried for a very long time. So they may want quick results here, and that could lead to a certain discord once again. So be a bit mindful of that. Okay, so that's all I have for you, Virgo. Take care. Love and light. Namaste.